Hey guys, I'm Erik Peterson, and I'm a men's dating and relationship coach for skillofattraction.com. And today's coaching video is called My Physical Looks Get Me Rejected. Now, as many of you know, these coaching videos is when one of you guys writes into me, and if I think it's a question that would be beneficial to my viewers and my subscribers, I answer your question in a video. And in today's email I got from a viewer, he had some pretty bad acne when he was younger, and due to some of the scars that's left on his face, he's a bit insecure with approaching women and talking with women, and he feels that it ends up getting him rejected. So I'm going to go through his email and give him some tips on how to boost his confidence a little bit so he could feel much better about approaching women and getting involved with women and ultimately have some success with women. But if you guys have any questions, please feel free to send me an email. All you have to do is head over to my website at skillofattraction.com, click on the contact tab, and shoot me a message from there. All I ask is that you keep your questions and your messages to me rather short and to the point, really just 1 to 2 paragraphs max. Otherwise, I'm just not going to have time to read through them all. But I will get back to you as soon as I can in either a written response or a video response like I'm doing today, where I will keep your personal information private. But I do have to take care of my paying clients first. So if you're just a little patient, I usually get back to you. Right now it's about 2 weeks as I'm a little behind. But if you want to get in touch with me right away, or you want to dive deeper into your situation, the best way to do that is, again, head over to my website at skillofattraction.com, click on the coaching tab, and there you'll see I have several options for you to choose from. I offer emergency email coaching that includes a response from me on weekends and holidays, and I also offer bi-weekly and monthly email coaching where I will work with you throughout that time period. And additionally, I offer phone coaching for my U.S. clients. Now, if you're outside the U.S., I will have something for you guys sometime in the future in terms of phone or Skype coaching. But for right now, email coaching is the way to go. I've had a few of you ask me outside of the U.S., when are you going to have phone coaching for us? I'm not really sure yet. I really haven't figured out the logistics in order to do all that. But like I said, email coaching is the way to go if you need to get in touch with me. And I will post a link to both my contact page and my coaching page in the description down below. So let's get on to his email. He says, "Hi, Erik. I had cystic acne really bad for 5 years as a teenager. I see really beautiful women. My heart beats fast. Then I still see myself as that acne-scarred kid around them feeling very ugly. If I do speak with them, I'm friend-zoned. Also, only child syndrome here, without male mentors." Yeah, that has been a big problem for the last couple generations, is a lot of boys have grown up without a father in the house or without a strong male role model. And I mean, it's become a real problem. I mean, obviously, single mothers are doing the best that they can, but boys do really need some sort of male role model in their life. He says, "To be clear, I'm not blaming women, I'm blaming me." That's good that you're taking responsibility and you're taking care of this yourself. It's not women's fault. It's not really your fault either, but it is your duty to do something about it. He says, "The truth is, I'm happiest when I'm not pining away obsessing over women." Well, we're all happiest that way. "Not sure anything can be done to fix this. I reached out to you because I really like your videos." Well, thank you very much. And I am going to answer your question. Okay, first you have to understand that it's not so much your physical appearance that's getting you rejected or friend-zoned, but it's your attitude about it. Of course, being an exceptionally good-looking guy is going to make it much easier for you to attract women and keep them around. I mean, looks are important to women, but not nearly as important as your behavior, your personality, and your overall attitude. And physical appearances certainly aren't as important to women as a woman's physical appearance is to us men. Sorry, ladies, but it's true. You're judged on your looks and your figure first and foremost. Unfortunately, there's not a lot you could do about that. It's just in our DNA, but I digress. It's important to understand that if you don't see your physical flaws as a big deal, women won't see them as a big deal either. And by physical flaws, I mean the things that you can't really do anything about. I mean, obviously, if you're overweight, there's something that you could do about that. But if you're short, there's really nothing you could do. So you have to learn to accept these flaws as part of who you are and embrace them. However, there are plenty of things that you could do to make yourself more attractive overall, as these things do matter to women. For one thing, not only is it good for you, but staying fit is going to be very attractive to women. I mean, this doesn't mean that you have to have muscles bulging out of your shirt, but staying in shape is important. Also, dressing with style is another thing that women really pay attention to, and it's going to make you feel more confident as well. I mean, now in these videos, the way I dress isn't a very good example of that, but when I go out, I do dress nice and I do dress with style. I mean, at least as stylish as I can be for a 47-year-old man. I mean, I don't try to dress like I'm 27, but I don't dress like I'm 47 either. And that's something for you older guys to think about. I mean, if you try to dress too young when you go out, you're going to look ridiculous. But that doesn't mean that you can't dress with style either. And another thing to think about is your grooming. I mean, get a nice haircut. Make sure your facial hair is well groomed. Make sure your nails are cut. Don't wear clothes that are all wrinkled. Wear some cologne. I mean, these are little things that women do pay attention to. And it could be something as small as your beard not being well groomed or your shoes not matching your belt that could be a deal breaker for them. I know it seems petty, but they like what they like. Also, having a little charisma could go a long way. I talk about this a lot in my videos. I mean, obviously, this has nothing to do with your physical appearance, but being well-groomed, dressed a little stylish, combined with some charisma and some confidence, I mean, I guarantee you're going to be getting some attention from some of the ladies. So really, you're just overthinking this a bit due to a fear of rejection. And it's really easy to begin using this as an excuse for you not to put in effort with women. I mean, you may be thinking to yourself, you know, why should I even bother? They're just going to end up rejecting me anyway due to this or due to that. And like I said before, you're not getting rejected or friend-zoned due to your physical appearance or your physical flaws. You're getting rejected due to a lack of confidence and thinking that they're going to reject you anyway. Essentially, it's a self-fulfilling prophecy. So you need to put your thoughts of being that acne-scarred kid aside, put on some stylish clothes, clean yourself up a little bit, stand up straight, put on a confident smile, and approach women with the attitude as, I'm just going to have a little fun with this. And you want to see your interaction with whichever woman you're talking to or whatever woman you're interested in as you're doing this to brighten up her day. And I realize that may sound a little dumb, but it's really just because you've never tried it before or no one's ever told you that this is the attitude that you should have. So just try it. I mean, you may not get the positive response that you're looking for at first, but never, ever in my life have I heard of a woman being downright mean to a guy just for trying. A lot of guys get this idea in their head that the woman's going to laugh at them or she's going to make them look like a fool, but I've never heard of that actually happening. So you want to just keep trying, and not only is it going to start getting easier for you, but you're going to start to notice that women are a lot more receptive to you, and they're going to start showing interest in you. I mean, not every single woman that you talk to is going to show interest, no matter who you are. So it's really a numbers game when it comes to dating and meeting women, and it's usually a small percentage that are going to show true, authentic interest in you. I mean, you want to have that attitude that you think that a majority of women are interested, but the truth is not many are going to be. So you can't take it personal. It's just how it is. And it's like that for everybody. So if you guys have found this video helpful or any of my videos helpful, I would really appreciate a thumbs up. and for you to share it with any of your friends and family. And I would also really appreciate it if you hit that subscribe button down below and tick that little bell symbol next to it so you get real-time notifications of when I upload new videos. And in the description down below, not only will I have a link to both my contact page and my coaching page, and I also have a link to some recommended reading, some great books that will help you further understand the psychology behind attraction and help you understand women better. I highly recommend you check those out. But I also have a link to PayPal if you deem this video worthy of a donation. So that's it for this video. I'll catch you guys on the next one. Have a good one. Bye-bye.